over to the MOC. Please take care.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Give your inaugural, very good inaugural address, sir. And I will tell you about the welcome address to chief person, that is speaker. Dr. is candidated as an education research officer at Vishnu Education Development Innovation Center, and short term we can call as VEDIC, run by Sri Vishnu Education Society, Hyderabad. Since has she conducted many workshops, the quality initiative, improvement in quality improvement in higher education, and also interested in more educational trends. And this PhD research his work is investigations on behavior analysis for improving learning practices. And the primary objective of research work is to build a student model for the intelligent tutoring system based on biopsychological potential. Degree from Anna University in May 2017 under the supervision of Dr. Rajiv Sukumar, IIT Madras. She obtained a Master of Technology in Computer Cognition Technology with distinction from University of Mysore and Bachelor of Engineering in Computer Science and Technology from VRS College of Engineering, Madras University. So spanning over 19 years, started from humble beginnings as software instructor in a computer class located in a remote town. She has the experience as a lecturer at Mahindra Engineering College and second seat in the Sri Krishna College, Coimbatore, the senior lecturer at Banaram Institute of Technology, Coimbatore, and then later promoted as assistant professor and Dr. NGP Institute of Technology, Coimbatore. She had also joined Aditya Institute of Technology, Coimbatore as assistant professor, which she had been promoted to the role of Associate Professor CSE and HOD of CSE ITB and Associate Professor Department of Information Technology at AIIMS Institute of Higher Education, Bangalore. She had the wonderful experience, interest, which have the core expertise in theory of computation and the use of ICT in teaching theory of computation. And studying faculty development programs and I have been covered 25,000 to 30,000 faculty members, including TTI, SERP, SWAYAM, DST, AACT, MHRD, Atal workshops. And she has been a jury for many national conferences and national student symposium. She has published 16 international conferences and 15 international papers and 5 patents professionally published. She has built a software model based on biophysics. Psychological potential coded on account of its test brain dominance, learning style preference, multiple intelligence, and personality. So it's named as KYC, Know Your Caliber. So the area of expertise of the madam is educational research methodologies, IQASIC, curriculum planning, learning assessment, improving learning using cognitive psychology based assessment, accreditation, and expertise in interactive video material creation as well as in video editing. I welcome you, madam, to deliver your speech. Up to you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Executive Director and ECHOD and the organizer and the coordinator of this sponsored workshop and all the faculty members of EC Department Excel Institute. I am happy to say that twice I visited your institution when I was in Coimbatore as an external examiner for the laboratory examination, twice, two different semesters. I have seen your institution as well. So the person who has seen your institution, I am associated with you today. I'm so delighted. Thank you, everyone. And I welcome all the participants and dignitaries and distinguished invitees of this AACT sponsored workshop. Today, I'm glad with you all to share an overview about Internet of Things, IoT. So today, there is no specific scope we will be having to discuss detail. Deeper, it's all about breadth. So what are all the layers or what are all the domains and interdisciplinary, multidisciplinary, what we need to catch up on? That is what I'm here to address about. Hope so my presentation is visible. My first slide is on Internet of Things and overview. I would like everyone, any one of you, please acknowledge me. My audio is comfortable and my...
Yes, sir, it is clear. It is clear. Thank you.
So much, yeah. So this is what we are going to address today, the holistic picture. then it has different layers, different functionalities. Then each and every other session will be towards the deeper discussion. It's a vertical discussion. Today, the first session, I would like to touch upon the breadth of the domain called IoT, because many participants, you may be joined today, very new to IoT also, you may be intermediate level or you may be advanced learner, whatsoever may be, we need to moderate the things. That is the reason we are interested to touch upon an overview today. I would like to say that IoT is a perfect example for both interdisciplinary kind of project, we can say, domain we can say, or multidisciplinary kind of domain we can say. This is what the perfect combination works out for both of terminology called interdisciplinary as well as multidisciplinary domain. So with that, how I do say this is interdisciplinary and multidisciplinary domain, let us short discussing in a couple of slides, after a couple of slides. So now I would like to know from the chat window, may know who is this person. Any clue, you can communicate in the chat window. Similarly, anybody attends through YouTube channel, they can communicate in the respective chat window. I would like to know at least a couple of response. Who is this? If you have idea, I'll give 1 minute. You can give the name of the personality. If I give you a text, you will get a clue. Google will support you. But now I have displayed an image. So you may need to go for image recognition. Only then Google will support you. Yeah, that's fine. So the person is Kevin Ashton. He is father of IoT. He is a person coined the terminology called Internet of Things and the basics or foundation. He is the person have brought this arena. He have not contributed too much, but the idea, initiation, the breakthrough, innovation called the domain, Internet of Things, brought by Kevin. So this is the first thing. We may need to start with gratitude. We may need to start thanking all the inventor. So that is the reason we want to start with him. Subsequently, this is the person. We all should feel proud of being Indian. Such kind of eminent scientists we do have, Dr. Arogya Swami Pal Raj. He is of person from India, especially Tamil Nadu. He born near Pollachi. He have brought the reformation or innovativeness towards high-speed Wi-Fi and 4G technology. He has a person, or he is a person introduced this technology, 4G. Right now, we are all enjoying with our own Jio, Airtel, 4G technology. Right now, things are moving towards 5G. The moment 5G is exists into the picture, immediately Industry 4.0 or 4.0, all other revolution will start, keep moving towards the rapid, fast manner. That is for sure. So now things are waiting, or things are in the developmental stage, or in the prototype stage, or test bed, whatever the way we want, we can say. Because of the 5G technology only, we are waiting for all those things to happen, to become true. There are countries already it is taking place, but more or less people are waiting for 5G technology. Now, I would like to start with one small activity. Even participants, those who are all attending in the YouTube, also can take part. The thing is, two commonly used processor or any processor which is required for IoT applications definition are at the end. What I say is crisp information about IoT. Whatever you know, you need to put it in this activity in the form of text information. Maximum it will permit 100 characters. So if you want to contribute to multiple, then you need to use two different messages to this activity. Finally, it will create one word cloud. So through that, I could able to understand what are all the perspectives, levels, or the depth of participants who are all taking part in this activity. So right now I will move on to that particular scenario. So this is what the particular activity I wanted to give you a brief It will have one QR code. You need to just use your QR code scanner. If you have in your mobile QR code code scanner, you can scan it. If not, there is a slido.com. There is a website will come. Then it will ask you to enter the code. If you enter code, then you can get connected with this activity. Immediately you can start responding whatever the idea or the definition or the familiarity with application or processor names which are all used for IoT, any perspectives, broad picture I'm giving. So you can start typing your answers or contribution. So with that, we can spend for another 5 minutes. This is a good amount of thing I wanted to spend with you all to understand. Slido.com is the website. So with that, I will start moving on. I will stop this sharing of screen. Is it visible? Join at slido.com. That screen is visible. I request any one of you to kindly acknowledge that is the screen. Otherwise, I need to stop the screen and I need to start sharing this. Okay, I'll change now. One minute. Is this visible now? You please, there are two different ways. You can scan this QR one way. Let us start quickly. Share your crisp answer regarding IoT. This is what I have kept the title of this activity. Or else you can log into slido.com. Then it will ask you to enter the code. You may need to enter this code. Then either way, you can participate into it. Then you may need to give your answer within 100 characters. So crisp answer. You are permitted to give multiple answer. However, you need to give crisp answer. Anything which you know about IoT, a bulletin word or a buzzword or any familiar application, you can start posting right now. So this is what I wanted to conduct for next 5 minutes in order to understand your proficiency. That's it. So that will give you a clue to where I need to move forward fastly, where I need to spend some time, where idea I will have. That is the reason I wanted to conduct. You please take part. Let me know if you find any difficulty. You can use chat window or anything. So this is the QR code. You can directly scan with the smart mobile application if you have. If not, you can move this one, slido.com, www.slido.com. Then you can enter this code. This pin, the moment you enter, you will be joining this event. Please contribute. I think not even single one have joined. Why is that? Let me know if there is any difficulty also. Please make use of the chat window. I'm not sure how many participants are here as well as in the YouTube. Directly you can scan on my screen using your mobile. Or else you can use this website, www.slido.com. And you can enter this pin in order to join with this activity. It's too late. At least by this time, one or two members would have joined. Yeah, very good. Someone joined. Thank you for your contribution. IoT has got applications, agriculture, traffic monitoring. Very good. If you wish to give multiple answers, you can give. If not, you please help others also to join here. Thank you. One contribution have arrived to this platform. Similarly, I would like to know about others' thought as well. You can even leave the Google, I guess. You can scan and you can take part in this, and you can come back and join the session after 5 minutes. Let me know if there is any difficulty. If not, please join as early as possible. Contribute your answers. Anything which you know, the processor which are all useful for the IoT development and application, name of the processor or any hardware, name of the sensor. I'm giving you a bigger perspective or spectrum. You can contribute in any way. Share your crisp answer regarding IoT. It's a very general and vague question only. There is no specific. So for now, only one member have joined into this activity and contributed as well. Let me know at least from the chat window if there is any difficulty. There are 18 members, at least 8 members if you join here, that would be good. Sir, is YouTube is also telecasted, sir? I request any one of the host or moderator to support me. Is YouTube is also telecasted?
Yes, ma'am. YouTube is also now telecast going on.
Ma'am, is there anyone finding difficulty with that, joining this activity from the YouTube? Let me know.
Okay, ma'am. I'll ask an informant.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay,
ma'am. Then at the end of the session also, I wanted to take it forward their questions if they post there. All
okay,
sensors
ma'am.
Interconnected.
Sure,
yes, thank you, ma'am.
Okay,
all
I'm
sensors
sure.
Interconnected. Yeah, interconnected through IoT. Yet another answer. Fantastic. One is towards application. One is towards the architecture. Another two member have contributed. Thank you for your contribution. Just you need to scan this QR, or you can join through this URL. www.slido.com with this. Yeah, if not, I thought you would be enthusiastically participating. There is no enthusiasm I could see as of now. The reason may be two things. Either you are not able to get connected through this activity, or you are not interested. That's it. Okay, still I'll keep it open, then I'll start changing. I'll move towards the presentation. I think it will lead a lot of wastage in time. Let me cover. Yeah. Now I would like to ask one more question. What is this product? If you only half a minute, I can give timing, or you can unmute. You can even use audio note also. If you wish to communicate in the audio note, could you able to see this product and understand what is all about this product? If you, any one of you know, a clue about this product is also sufficient. I request you to take part in the chat window. If you know about this product, either name of the product or whatever you know about this product, the story behind of this product, anything, if you know, you please communicate. If not, let me proceed. Okay, so from why I'm asking question, not to trouble you, just I wanted to make you to become aware of, just you need to be alert mode. You need to be in the learning mode. The need arises anyone to learn. So you need to think there is a need to understand this concept, need to know this terminology, the need arises. So only two slides I will question, rest all no more question, don't worry of it. So this is the product. Shark Tank is one of the American business reality television series. Netflix, you can participate. You know about this Shark Tank, American business reality television. So this event, what it will do is anyone, either you and me, anyone can go and present our product, innovation, idea, or the complete product, anything, a prototype, a design, utility model, anything we can present in front of this Shark Tank panel. So that is a panel. This is an event name. Shark Tank is an event name. So once if the investors, they will, there are plenty of investors would be taking part in this event. Once if they are impressed with our product, immediately they are ready to invest whatsoever may be the cost for the manufacturing or for the business promotion. So with this introduction, I want to tell you, this is a product called a video doorbell. There is a video wherever the house owner may be available, either inside the home or outside the home. Those who are pressing this bell, those who are all touching this bell, or those who are all near to this camera focus, immediately it will be scanned and it will be sent to the people. Jenny Simon of, he is the inventor of this product. What is the story behind it is, Jenny started presenting this product in front of Shark Tank investors. None of them got impressed. Everyone rejected this product. Then he didn't give up. Then immediately he went to Amazon promotion, his own manufacturing unit in the small scale he started. Then he started going and promoting into the Amazon platform. Immediately Amazon, based on the review, based on that product quality and promotion and the customer satisfaction all together, they started appreciating this product. Immediately they started taking this, owning this product, all the innovation, copyright, everything from Jemmy. Now he is one of the millionaire, as also I can say billionaire. Now this is a person rejected. Now this is a person started sitting into the Shark event panel as a investor. The way he started the journey is a common layman like an investor. Now he is one of the now he is one of the panel member. That is a story I wanted to tell. Anything which we do, this Jam Siphon, now he is investor. He was like a presenter or innovator. Now he is an investor. That level he reached. This is the story behind of this product. Nothing more. Anything which we attempt and which we do towards IoT, we can think in terms of product, in terms of project, or in terms of patent, either design patent or utility patent, or in terms of inviting the investors for manufacturing in the large scale. So there is a lot of scope for every one of us to become millionaire and billionaire also with this domain called IoT. So this is the introduction I wanted to start with. Now, the evolving Internet of Things ecosystem. Ecosystem in the sense, what are all the components or services or modules or knowledge or intellect required in order to become true, or the product to be successful in manufacturing or in promotion or in services. If you look at what not is available is the question. If we start with this hardware, sensor, chips, service, device, objects, networks, these all related to hardware. So once the hardware is ready, next, software connectivity, platforms. IoT requires a platform to implement and work on KDS, cloud and software apps. So next is rules. We need to understand rules, standards, protocols, consortiums, industry groups and regulations, and government rules. There are several countries, they are against of invention related to IoT, or application or bringing to the reality is opposed. So that we need to understand. Every country, the regulation towards IoT is differing. It varies. Integrating solutions, then how we can integrate with each and every domain. Already towards that activity, someone mentioned it is related to agricultural domain, traffic management, and someone said interconnection of several sensors. So after interconnection, where we want to bring the solution, IT services and management, how we can bring it to IT sector, this IoT, data analytics and security. This is what the complete focus of this ACT fund, the complete security concern only predominantly it will be discussed. However, it is required to move with the foundation. That's the reason we are starting with. So once ecosystem is understood, what are all the required skill set in order to work with IoT in the large scale? Small scale project is different. What is a small scale project is, for example, you can automate light on off. I hope so you can able to see what I am eating. Anyone please acknowledge, moderator. I'm using the Epic Pen. I'm not sure, never used Epic Pen with a Google Meter. Normally Zoom, it has its own annotation tool. I'm using Epic Pen. I'm writing light. Light, soft light, smart light, we can say. Are you able to see what I'm writing using pen? Pink color.
Ma'am, excuse me, where, ma'am? In which, in the slide or?
Pink color pen, I'm using and writing on the slide. Is it visible, ma'am?
No.
On the pen.
It's not visible, ma'am.
I'm using Epic Pen, I have written smart light. Is it visible? Hello?
Ma'am, it's not visible, ma'am.
I couldn't hear anything.
Ma'am, it's not visible.
Hello, could you see smart light?
Ma'am, no, ma'am. 11 vital skills to become an IoT developer. That's literally weaving, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. It is not recognizing. There is no use of using this Epic Pen. Okay, ma'am. I'll close this Epic Pen. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah, I got it. Now, for example, smart light. The moment we bring smart light, the moment we implement smart light for one particular house alone, maybe your own house or you may be doing for your experimental project or academic project, that's fine. So that doesn't require this much skill. The moment you become vendor, smart light automation system, anything you want to deploy across several houses, you should have the tracking mechanism. You should have the troubleshooting mechanism. You should have the maintenance mechanism. You should have the upgradation mechanism. Then you would be attempting towards large scale. Every device, every kit, you will be generating unique identifier through in which you were working with the product in the large scale manner by the time it is required. Machine learning among 11 vital skills, this is what the first skill people are putting forth in the fore desk and front desk. Consider the crucial role of sensors, several sensors. Nowadays, people are moving towards green IoT. Meaning, the moment we bring green IoT, either no power consumption, there are circumstances, especially traffic control management, weather forecasting and flood forecasting, earthquake forecasting, and what else, the related to agricultural automation, everywhere sensors are required to be deployed densely, larger number group sensor or larger number sensors. By the time we need to think of green IoT, definitely large scale means we need to think of green IoT. What is the meaning green IoT? Energy consumption should be lower, or it should go for green energy utilization, like solar energy, wind energy, for the self-sustenance or for the electricity. Every component, if you look at the complete IoT infrastructure, 50% the attention goes to hardware, 50% the attention goes to the software. So software need to be executed, processor need to be on, sensors need to be sensing, and all the routers need to function, all the gateways, all the nearby analytical component, edge component, and the fog computation, cloud computation, cloud lit. I will be discussing each and every terminology, nothing to do. So it is surrounded with a lot of hardware, wireless sensor network or Wi-Fi component or modem, anything may be. Ethernet communication or LoRa communication or Bluetooth communication, anything, let it be. It is required the power. Without power, IoT is nothing. So that people are addressing towards green IoT. So this is also a scope. Manufacturing a new kind of sensors, new kind of actuators suitable for the green IoT, or cost-wise reduction. Either cost-wise reduction, we can keep inventive, or the consumption, electricity consumption-wise also we can keep inventive. So this is another avenue and arena. UI-centric approach. The moment we say IoT, UI is a common layman, a consumer, a public, or particular vendor, or that consumer or the user will be interacting with your product. So UI should be more powerful, or UI experience should be good enough. So development of UI or what to say, your user interface is another required skill in the domain of IoT. Knowledge of JavaScript and Python is also essential for the web services and web activity. Proven skills in Node.js, this is for backend technology or full stack technology. What is full stack is front end, back end, and complete server handling. All together, it is termed as full stack. And DB also, DB, front end, back end, inclusive of server handling, web services also. These four together can be termed as full stack. So this is also essential. Security infrastructure and engineering is essential. I'd be addressing upon a few sensor level attack itself. Involved with big data. So this all the data, how need to be stored, how need to be retrieved, how need to be processed, how need to be taken decisions, in-stream analytics and batch processing, offline analytics. There are two different analytics they need to take care. AutoCAD for the prototype designing or the product designing, AutoCAD. Then GPS development, cloud computing, hardware requirement, these all those together a vital skill required. Now you may be perhaps understanding what is interdisciplinary, what is multidisciplinary. The moment the sensor comes into the picture, the moment the hardware comes into the picture, definitely there is a role of electrical or electronics specialist. The moment AutoCAD comes into the picture, definitely mechanical expert need to contribute. All other related to either interdisciplinary, you can say, or computer science. So I doesn't mean that UI is developed only by computer science guy. Nowadays, EC guys also equally good enough in developing UI interface, developing a Python code, developing full stack architecture, something. So it's a kind of interdisciplinary as well as multidisciplinary. Coming to this, what is IoT? Now only the session starts. So for now, I wanted to give some warm up. So now Internet of Things. Anytime, any context, Internet of Things applicable, anytime it will work, any data it can process, any device should be comfortable for processing the data or connecting with the Internet of Things, any place, any way, any service, any business, any part, any network. That is why I can say IoT is a clumsy and complex also. So it has everything. People are ready to bring. Thing means Internet of Things. Things means what? Living thing, non-living thing. It can be a plant, it can be a dustbin, or it can be a vehicle, or it can be a robot, or it can be a human, or it can be a wrist too much. It can be anything. It can be a camera. So the thing means inclusive of both living being, non-living being. So that's why Internet of Things. Anything is possible. Any data, any device, path. Any path means wireless, wired, again optical wired and cable wired, anything, any path, any network, any service. Local area also is possible. Wi-Fi is also possible. Without the internet also we can do with a low range communication protocols we can do. No need to go for internet services. But communication is required, essential. Any business, it is suitable for any sector. sector, 24 sector, health sector, civil engineering sector, smart manufacturing sector, any sector is applicable, not necessarily agriculture. Industry automation is also fully dependent on IoT. So this is what I wanted to start with, the definition of IoT. Subsequently, when we look at a global standard initiative, IoT definition itself, we can address for more than 4 hours. So that many definition, that many contributions people have given towards this. If you look at any time connection versus any connection on the move, outdoor, indoor, at the PC, all the four combination, any place, based on time and place. Based on thing and time, time and the object, daytime, night time, indoor, outdoor, on the move, anything, because over on the move only it is working. They have IoT integrated chip. Nowadays it is possible to detect, maybe 5 to 8 years ago you would have noticed a lot of mischiefs with women travelers, women passengers with Ola as well as Uber. Then subsequently nowadays they have the kit that need to be installed in the Ola and Uber vehicles. The moment the passenger gets in, either one of their mobile, either driver mobile or passenger mobile, need to be switched on till the end of the journey. If both the mobiles are switched off, it will be tracked, it will be indicated, control room will get an alert. If both switch it off, then immediately it will find out the location, geographical location of that vehicle where it is. Then they can send the nearby vehicle for anything to be monitored, or any suspicious things are happening to be given alert by any other vehicle. Nowadays they have a lot of security mechanisms. So that is the reason I want to touch upon here. On the move also it is possible. Any place and thing and place, between C also possible, human to human, H2H is also possible, M to M, machine to machine is also possible, thing to thing is also possible, thing to thing is also possible, or machine to machine, or there is one more also, they miss it here, machine to machine. You think two different things can communicate each other. So this is the ultimate definition I can see. In my point of view, I'm telling, I appreciate this International Telecommunication Union definition than any other definition. So coming to here, that is what communication. Then analytics. So based on that, you can analyze. Initially you can install the smart light and gather the data. Using the data, you can automate or you can build the model. Then intelligent light. You can say that intelligent light. Initially you can say that IoT, a smart light. You can say then you can say intelligent light. So these are all the way. This is a basic or rudimentary level of understanding IoT, three layers or three component or three major phases. It's the sensing. What and all you can sense, what not. Nowadays, I can say minimum 500 plus sensors available to my knowledge, I'm telling. I don't know exactly how many sensors are available. Position, presence, proximity, even in your mobile, the touch sensor is available. So you will conduct one small activity, either at the middle of the session or end of the session. How many sensors available in your mobile itself is an amazing phenomenon. So every one of our smart mobile has minimum of 10 to 12 sensors. Then motion sensor, velocity, displacement, this motion sensor, velocity, all for fluidity, the dam and all the flood detection or dam infrastructure detection, smart monitoring, for those wherever the fluids are available, even for mining, the petrol mining. So the velocity is understood. Temperature sensor, humidity or moisture sensor, acoustic sound vibration sensor, chemical gas sensor for the pH value understanding or chemical molecule understanding. There are several sensors nowadays available for the chemical applications, gas applications, flow control, wall control or flow control sensor or flow detecting sensor. Similarly, force, load, torque, strain, pressure, these all can be gauged or can be monitored. Leakages and levels, these are all nowadays available. Most of the house, they are having this smart tank filling, that water tank, they will be installing automatically. This will be switched on, switched off. This all, the moment indicator says that the level of water in the tank is lower, then motor will be switched on. Then the level it reached, then motor will be switched off. So electric magnetic field identification sensor, acceleration tilt. So this all the acceleration tilt sensor is available in our mobile itself. So based on that only, you are keeping the orientation. The moment you keep vertical, the mobile, all the picture or movie which you are watching will be in the vertical. Then the moment you flip in the horizontal, it will be in the horizontal. Machine vision, optical, ambient light. So then camera sensor, so many sensors available, just to have a fair idea about sensor. Because most of the time, something need to be sensed from the environment. After sensing only, we can take it forward for the automation. So first level is sensing. So that sensing, we need to understand where we are sensing, what domain, what problem statement or what environment. So this is a base or core we need to understand sensing. Even few of my friends used to have discussion with me for this particular, for example, smart tunneling, that is sanitizer tunneling. Nowadays, the moment the corona effect has come, no, they started installing a lot of tunnels. The moment a person gets in, need to be sprayed. Then the moment goes away, exits from the tunnel, needs to be stopped. So that spraying also need to be controlled these many seconds. Then how need to be done? Then PIR sensor, range sensor. So like that, the discussion have come. Sensors need to be identified first, subsequently communication. What is the way our complete infrastructure, how much distance it is available, what is the modality of communication, where to where, what are all the things connected, whom to whom we need to communicate, that decides the communication type. See, for example, short range wireless communication, Zigbee is famous, to the secondary. Yes, communication. This is what rocking now. NFC is the latest, I can say, and NFC is rocking the best or appreciating short range wireless communication. People are telling what is NFC is with a card and a touch card and with a payment device. You can tap these two, then immediately you can start communicating. Two different devices can communicate, NFC. If these two, any two mobiles are tapped together, the recent Samsung mobiles are having these all NFC. So NFC enabled. In my mobile, I don't have, I have on Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, these all. So these are all the way we need to choose a communication. Depending upon the application only we can choose. Whether we move to cellular communication, this is suitable for long range communication, larger infrastructure, mini node and sparse or dense infrastructure, definitely we need to go for which category, 3G, 4G, 5G, that we need to decide. And low pan, LP1, LoRa, Sigfix. Yeah, LoRa is useful for within the near field faster communication. So for example, agricultural field. So within your land, you may be having 5 acres, 10 acres. Within that range, if you want to go for fastest communication, then you need to choose LoRa. So I have written few points here when to use. The moment you step into your IoT project, I have few thumb rule. Very first thing is purpose and requirements. We need to list out our purpose and requirements. Process model specification, all the use cases, where and all is applicable, what are all the abuses. Then domain model specification, physical entity, virtual entity, devices, resources, services in the IoT system, we all need to list out clearly. Information model specification, the structure, how the information is communicated across different entities, what are all the relationships, how many attributes are associated, what is the type of data, nature of data, service specifications, what is the mapping services, mapping device to communication mapping, communication to application layer mapping or user mapping. So all the mapping process. IoT level specification. The level specification, in the sense I will touch upon that levels. So whether you are working in cluster of node or single node or multiple node, something edge computation, fog computation, cloud computation, cloud-led computation or mixed computation, that is called level in simple term I can say. Similarly, functional view specification, operational view specification, what are the services, device and component integration, deployment, application development, all together you may need to list out first. Depending upon that only, the particular technology or protocol or the hardware can be chosen. There is no thumb rule for IoT to start with. For the academic project, I can start with either start with Arduino or you can start with Raspberry Pi. So what is those two difference? Let us see shortly. In analytics, so the moment data generated, acquisition, gathering of the data, marshalling, then conversion of the data, completely the format need to be changed. The representation need to be changed. That is called marshalling, analysis, and action. So once the data is accumulated, then how to take about. See, Ola and Uber, imagine every city control will be playing with minimum 1 lakh vehicle, or I can say minimum 10,000 cars associated with their business. So imagine 10,000 cars, they need to acquire the data first, then marshal the data, analyze the data, action on process. Immediately they need to take decision, at time they need to take decision a bit later. So all together they need to work on this. Next, now only we are coming to little more deeper understanding of IoT architecture. See, sensing layer or hardware, what are all the hardware we want to work with? That we need to first complete. Hardware connectivity, power distribution, how many resistors we need to use, where to control the power, how many pull-up resistors we need to use, how many pull-down resistors we need to use, is there a requirement of capacitor. Every device attached with your infrastructure will have different voltage, the complete power management, voltage distribution, so that voltage calculation, that all those things need to be taken care in the sensing layer or hardware layer. Next, network layer, how we are connecting together all the things. Things means what? It can be living being or non-living being. How need to be connected? Only with the support of network layer. So how these two things can be connected or different things can be connected, that we need to work it out. Similarly, how we need to process. Whether you are doing simple automation also, data need to be processed. That how the data need to be processed, data need to be gathered, data need to be stored, and data need to be analyzed. All those things together, action need to be given. Similar, gateway's main role, main component in the network layer, local gateway, or it is international gateway, anything you can consider. Then local gateways are related to your own network for device identification or device communication protocol, something like that. Then when the moment we go for proxy server, international gateway, that is for WWW standard. The WWW standard, the messages need to be communicated, need to be authenticated. So for that, gateway is useful. Processing unit. So next processing unit, GPU, TPU, CPU, any type of processor. There are three types of processor recent days exist. CPU, central processing unit, graphics processing unit, GPU and TPU. Then application layer. So what is the way we want to the infrastructure, medical application, it is different, and the fleet services, all the transport services, it is different, and all the end user, a public user services are different. So it is depending on the application we need to work on. So first we need to synthesize these four major layer in our project. So now little more detailed I'm bringing to the scenario of IoT solution architecture, sensors and actuators. First we need to understand what are all sensors and actuators involved in our project. Then that type, wired and wireless, that we need to synthesize faster. What is actuator? Finally, the end product need to be automated or controlled is actuator. There's no single definition. Nowadays, polymer actuators are coming into the picture. That is one of the green IoT control. Similarly, people are designing sensors based on green IoT concept. Nowadays, both the sensors and actuators, both are based on green IoT. Similarly, cars also, temperature sensor alone, you can find more than 10 types to 20 types of temperature sensor alone, I'm telling. So depending upon the material which they use, durability, reliability, and all those things, and the power consumption, these all together, it is the price is fixed. And sensor is going to sense something. This is the initiating layer of the architecture. What is actuator? Finally, what is action we need to take upon the complete communication is actuator. For example, motor. Our home, we have most of our, at least our no person would be installed with IoT based, motor control. So your motor valve, electrical signal need to be converted into mechanical torque. So that torque will take action on the actuator. It will control when to switch on your valve or the motor, when to switch off your motor. So completely motor need to be activated. In this scenario, motor is an actuator. Smart light automation. The moment you look at smart light automation, sensing is what? Intensity of light or anything, object. Either based on street lights or based on intensity of the light, illumination. Whereas house, it needs to work based on the human. At least it should have a mobile control. Be at a different room or you can be away from your home. You should be in the position to control the switch. So based on the sensing medium, actuator need to be. Without sensor also, actuator can work, please understand. But without actuator, no sensors are useful. There is no need of sensors. Directly you can control through UI also. It is possible. But actuator is important. Actuator comes to picture for take decision, automatic decision mainly. We are going for IoT. Then actuator is must. Next, internet gateway or local gateway. Local gateway is for your device control or the main purpose of gateway is for authentication and communication. So in and out of data, flow control of data or messages, information are controlled by gateway. Data acquisition, data aggregation. These are all together the second stage. Next, edge IT. IoT or edge analytics or fog computing, there are two different words. I have different slide for those two. However, I will give you a small introduction about edge computation or edge analytics or edge processing, edge computation. Computation. These are all the two computations are focused. Anyone wanted to do research or submit a paper, the hit of the paper, success rate of the paper would be much more better for edge computation or edge analytics, fog computation or fog analytics. These two. What is these two? Let me come to the picture. Edge computation is on the node, on the device itself, either node or the device, there are some recent day coming with the processing ability. Otherwise, you need to deploy a separate circuit. The moment the sensor data is brought to that device, immediately nearby that sensor, the moment or nearby the actuator, wherever, it needs to do analytics. Immediately decision needs to be taken. For example, camera, surveillance camera, anything goes real out, public nuisance or public fight is happening, immediately the server camera need to deduct that and need to immediately give an alert. So there is no more delay. So every frame of the video is analyzed periodically, at least once in a minute interval. So it needs to give an alert to the nearby police station or nearby concerned. By the time if delay happens, what would happen? Something wrong. So that analytics need to be done on the device itself in order to take decision. So that is edge analytics, edge computation. What is fog computation? You may have single node or multiple node. Node means what? Hardware. Elements, I can say. Hardware, circuits, I can say. Number of component, I can say. So you can establish a local area network. For example, if you are going agriculture automation, it is not necessary to connect it to cloud at all. You can do a local area network establishment within your 5 acres, 10 acres, you can start doing automation. So within your range, you need to do analytics. It may have several sparse densely deployed sensors. So much unit you may have, irrigation unit you may have, then pest reduction unit you may have, or soil dryness reduction, pH value reduction. Imagine you have different perspectives. Then every component will have separate unit. All unit together need to be processed in the local area network. That is called fog computation. For one particular node, if the analytics is carried out, that is called edge computation. Multiple nodes in the local area network, if you want to do a computation, that is called fog computation. But however, both are done nearby the device itself, architecture itself. The moment you deploy or acquire or gather the data into the cloud, after bringing all the data into the cloud for analytics, that is called cloud computation. So these two vary from perspectives. So the moment you go for cloud computation, what is the problem is latency delay. Your data need to go to the cloud, there in which the analysis to happen, then the actuator, controlling the actuator or decision making would become big delayed, latency delay. That is the reason we cannot rely on Wi-Fi all the time. Although internet is good, by our tower need to work. Our network, you may belong to any one of the telecommunication service, Airtel or whatever, that BSNL, whatever. So we don't know how the quality on that day, the traffic on that day. So we cannot rely on that. So certain primary analytics need to be done at the edge level or done at the fog level. That is one scenario. What is the need of going for edge analytics and fog computation is another scenario. Cloud is costly affair. You can't dump all the information whichever comes from the sensors or whichever comes from the input data on the cloud. You need to take decision. What are all the data essentially useful? Data transmission or data selection or data filtering or feature extraction. Finally, essential data need to be deployed into the cloud. So that people are mostly concentrating towards recent days on the edge computation and the fog computation. How it can become successful in order to reduce the cost of the cloud, how the edge computation can be improved, how the fog computation can be improved is a point of discussion going on. If you look at, there are 4 stages this slide demonstrate. Every stage, the security is required. Sensor level security is required. Gateway level security or firewalls or all the proxies required. Then edge level, computation level also required. Cloud level is also required. Security is required in every layer or every level. So there are devices people are manufacturing, a ready-made kit, ready-made platforms people are manufacturing with more security when it comes to stage one. Similarly, stage two, we need to sit and study which protocol, which mode of communication have different way of security mechanism, and what are all the protocol suits with what are all the type of firewalls or kind of antivirus, so many things. So this all need to understand, and we need to deploy all along into this level. Every layer, we need to think security. So that is what the focus of this STTP alone. Let me stick to the overview of that rather than the security. So this is what the holistic picture. Again, coming to here, one more holistic picture I want to bring. Gateway, so sensors, actuators, and all the smart devices connected to the gateway. The moment we call it as a device, any hardware device comes, every device must have unique identification code. Without that unique identification code, any signal comes from the device, gateway will not process, will not understand, will not accept. So that is where the gateway is essential. You can say at your end, local gateway can be your hub, your router, and what is that internet gateway? Completely, that is centralized. That allows any communication to happen based on WWW standards, World Wide Web standards, or HTTP protocol standards. So it works on either HTTPS or HTTP protocol or WWW consortium standard. That is internet gateway. So when you want to bring your internet IoT infrastructure, internet, of things, anything you do, if you want to bring into internet, then you need to be in the need of internet gateway. Otherwise, local gateway is sufficient. So one router is sufficient to establish your local area network. The moment any device we bring into communication or attachment to the internet or local area network, definitely gateway is required. The moment you wanted to connect two different devices together itself, you need a gateway. Then cloud gateway. This is for finally to store your gateway, web application or mobile application. You need to decide for the user point of view or both. User business logic, data analytics. See, sensor data. From the sensor data, it goes to data lake. Raw data go to data lake. What is data lake? I will shortly address. So this is a buzzword. Recently, the moment you say big data, people moved on to the data lake. What is the data lake? Shortly, we'll discuss sensor data. From the sensor data, big data warehouse and control applications. Finally, it should control. So from the control application, there are machine learning model. If you wish, you can go. Not necessarily to have the whatever it is projected on this picture. This is for a bigger, a massive scale enterprise applications. For example, Ola, Uber. These are enterprise applications. All the cargo services, flight services. Every flight is attached with thousands and thousands of sensors. The moment one flight is operated from one city to another city, 1 hour, the voluminous of data which you are imagining to the cloud application, it will be tremendous. So those kind of application only, whatever it is projected on this, it is essential. So streaming data processor, sometime the moment the data arrives, streaming time itself need to be processed. Cloud gateway, the moment you want to deploy internet through cloud, then you need to use this cloud gateway. Then control applications, from the control application, the flow comes to user business logic. That is what I said initially. You need to identify the problem statement, domain, and all the internet communications and all the services which you want to provide. That is, we need to have a complete template or flowchart or mind map. Only then IoT, you can make it to become successful. Otherwise, it is very tough. You can't do trial and error. We need to have concrete idea. what application we want to do, relevant to that we need to go in deeper. The moment I say ZigBee communication protocol, what is ZigBee? I may know only the definition right now, but the moment I prefer ZigBee is required for my particular application, I need to go in and out how I can do coding to bring ZigBee, and how, what are all the pros and cons of ZigBee, case studies, what are all the existing use case studies, all I need to do, brainstorm, I need to understand, I need to take decision. So the cost is a matter. Anything which we know we can't deploy, we need to think for scalability, adaptability, and what to say, configuration. The anything we want to upgrade, you suppose you may be doing 4G, later on you need to upgrade with 5G, then configuration, that all those things it needs to withstand. So that we need to understand what is useful, what is our future business scenario, what is our present business scenario, all together we need to connect. Depending upon that, we need to go for architectural development. Now second question, is IoT and CPS are same, cyber physical system are same? Yes, both are same. The moment you say cyber physical system, machine to machine, all the non-living things, only machines can get connected. That is the only difference. All other things are same. IoT means human machine, machine to machine, all those combinations together. When it becomes cyber physical system, I can say M to M, I can say. That's it. So coming to here, sensors. Let us touch upon a little bit of sensor. Actually, we have only 45 minutes or exactly 1 hour more. I may not conduct activity. I used to have a small activity, giving the scenario, asking the audiences to list out what are all the sensors we can think for this scenario, that kind of activity I used to do. But due to the time constraint, let me move on to this. So, for example, if you are going to do anything DST-sponsored, CERBU-sponsored, MHRD-sponsored, AICT-sponsored projects, anything sponsored projects only, I mean to say, or if you are well-off, you need to rely on Libilium. You search the internet, Libilium is a product vendor. So this has, they have their own website, Libilium product. So you can purchase this. This is reliable, industrial graded. So it, the, what are all the product they are selling in the Libilium platform, they will be, they all are graded by the industrial benchmark and standard. That is the worth or highlight of Libilium. When you go for Alibaba, Alibaba has plenty. That fellow sells whatnot. So I cannot assure for your quality. You may get a cheaper sensor also through Alibaba, or you may not get a cheaper sensor. That whatever may be, I cannot assure for the reliability of that sensor. Similarly, Amazon also, if you purchase, I cannot assure. So if you purchase through IEEE standards, then reliability is good, much better. But this is one of the commercial website, I mean to say, other than technical consortium, if you want to buy, or you can buy Texas Instrument, that is your choice. But commercial, I mean to say, Libilium, this comes with industrial graded. Then photodiode, photo transistor, ambient licensing, smart light, if you want to do, you need to identify all the sensors suitable for that application. Then you need to understand the pros and cons of each and every sensor. So that is what I mean to say, you need to go for exhaustive study. Depending upon your domain application, I myself cannot sit and study all the sensors. I cannot become expert on all the sensors unless otherwise I work on sensor. So similarly, movement, the PIR sensor, passive infrared sensor. So for example, social distancing alert, there are several applications people have developed during this pandemic. So this will give the alert. So the person comes more than 1 meter closer to you, then PIR sensor, anything. This one PIR sensor, vehicle parking is required. PIR sensor, where it is required, just imagine. Anything, prohibited area, if you enter, it will give you alert. So there are several applications for the PIR sensor. You please go through it. Then pressure sensor, all the water related, either wastewater treatment or water metering, future how current meters are available. Similarly, water metering going to be deployed. Already several countries, those who have water scarcity, they have water metering technology. Barometer, flow and level sensors, pH value, TDS and pH sensor, these are all the sensors. Differential pressure, transducers, flow sensors, magnetic sensor. Whenever you go into dams, flow, water inflow, water outlet outflow, or tank, everywhere you need to have differential pressure transducers. So next, coming to this all, you may be amazed what this all. This is called Arduino Shield. Arduino has basic kit. Arduino is a microcontroller, whereas this Raspberry Pi is a processor. Similarly, this instrument, the CC3200, one kit is available. That is also a processor. The moment we say processor, this processor can be used for the real-time application. Whereas Arduino, maximum real-time application, yeah, small applications you can think of. But Arduino is best suitable for academics with a cheaper cost. Arduino, only even by tomorrow, I would be addressing in another session, one more session I am invited. Completely, I'll be addressing about Arduino academic projects, hands-on with the coding. So Arduino coding, we will be discussing. By the time, we will come to know. Suppose you want to bring Arduino for something like a real-time application with application, then you need to bring a Wi-Fi shield. There are two layers you can see. It's like a deck. The top layer is a shield for Wi-Fi. A bottom layer is a Arduino microcontroller kit. Similarly, this Lilypad Arduino, you look at this circle like this is a very, very thin and tiny Arduino. Arduino itself has minimum 5 to 7 variant, different flavors of Arduino available. This Lilypad Arduino, even we can stitch in our cloth itself. This Arduino kit we can carry in our cloth, in our dress itself we can stitch. Next, this is called Particle I.O. The last one I'm showing, Particle I.O. This is for handy applications. You can understand. See how much smaller it is when it compared to all other devices. This is Intel, their own IoT processor kit. See, this Intel is useful. 1 minute. This Intel is useful for especially industrial application. This is Intel. Intel created for industrial application. The top one, black one, Node MCU. This is for green IoT. This is IoT. This IoT platform for green IoT. The moment we start discussing about sensor, where we need to connect is the discussion. For that, you require some platform. Raspberry Pi, Arduino, or Intel, Cisco also, they have their own. IBM also, they have their own. Every vendor, they have their own controller. If you see today, several, plenty. BeagleBone, I'll be discussing a little bit later about those. So these are all the, this is Particle I.O. We need to find out the kit for our establishment. This Particle.io is useful for handy application. Anything which you want to carry while traveling, or it should look elegant at your home, then you need to go for this Particle I.O. This is for industrial automation. This is a platform you need to buy and you need to develop application, not the Arduino or Raspberry Pi. Industry perspectives. This is green IoT, completely low power consumption microcontroller or processor. So this is what the Node MCU. So these are all those fair idea we should have. Even I don't know everything, whatever I know, but this awareness is required. Sensor awareness and the platform awareness is required. Only then you can move forward. So first we need to decide the domain and the use case. What we need to take. Then similarly, next to the sensor, you need to work on actuator as well. Actuator I'm not bringing because no time to sit and prepare this slide, although I know few actuators. So let us move on to the next. Now the hardware layer I discussed, or I had given a glimpse. I am not addressing a detail, some fair idea, justice I'm doing for this session. So similarly, actuators, IoT technologies and protocols. So you have several protocol: Bluetooth, ZigBee, Z-Wave, cellular, Wi-Fi, NFC. Cellular is 1G, 2G, 3G, 4G. You are talking about that LoRaWAN. So which one you want to go for? That decided by your use case. There is no general idea. No, I cannot tell this is what the better. what is application you want to develop. Similarly, NFC is recent day more people are working on NFC. Near field communication, this near field communication is working based on RFID, infrared identification. So what are all the way you can use? You can see, look at this picture and you can able to understanding and the cash payment and what else, identification, a human identification through your tag and physical access to different machines you can communicate each other. So this is what application you can think of using NFC. IoT protocol, the famous protocols I'm telling for IoT protocols. This is in general based on the ranges. Again, I have several slides to give you clarity when to use what. Shortly, we'll be discussing. So most of widely used protocols only I have brought in, COAP. The COAP is called Constrained Application Protocol. This is useful for M2M communication, machine-to-machine communication, two different machines you want to automate or communicate here, then you need for M2M. Similarly, IoT system based on HTTP protocol only you can use. The moment you bring HTTP only, CoAP can be used. The most widely popular, big appreciated protocol is MQTT protocol. So that MQTT protocol I'm discussing in the subsequent slide in detailed manner. Message queue telemetry transport protocol. This is much more important. This has security. Next is advanced message queue protocol, AMQP protocol. This uses publisher subscriber model. It uses the data structure called queues. So through queues, it will be all the publisher will deposit in the queue. The messages are deposited in the queue. Subscriber will start accessing the queue for fetching. Whereas in the MQTT broker, there is one more broker, Mosquito broker. Mosquito broker. So these Mosquito broker is variant of the latest version variant of MQTT broker. MQTT protocol is also working based on publisher subscriber model. Only the difference is MQTT broker is sitting and giving authentication between the publisher and the subscriber. None of the publisher and the subscriber cannot communicate to each other. Only through MQTT broker only the communication is possible. That is the only difference between MQTT and AMQP. Although it looks like same, MQTT is preferred a lot by the audiences or the developers. Data distribution service. So this is useful for scalable, massive level communication like Ola, Uber, we are telling, or flight services, real time, reliable. Excessive overall performance is you are expecting precise performance. Flight services, something goes wrong, what will happen? All the VIP will be traveling. So it needs to be ship. All the movement, the cargo movement need to be detected. Interoperable statistics are recovered. By that time only you need to use DDS. Just because of the appreciation, we can use small level of development. So it is expensive. So we need to decide what application we want to do, how long we need to run business, what is the future expansion. All those things we need to connect in our mind, only then we can decide the IoT protocol. Now we are going for MQTT protocol, a little bit discussion. Look at here, humidity sensor deposits the data to MQTT broker, then on-premise analytics, cloud analytics, both are possible. But through broker only you can take data. So without broker, directly you can't access and you can't communicate. So this MQTT broker is responsible for authentication. That is a highlight or advantage. Through that you can improve the security. So now it is essential when the response time, throughput, lower battery and bandwidth usage if you are preferring, then you need to use MQTT protocol. Green IoT, it supports only MQTT. MQTT is a lightweight protocol that runs on top of the TCP/ICP protocol. There are two protocols, UDP, TCP/ITP for the network communication. So among those two protocols, MQTT is suitable with TCP/ICP protocol. So this uses public subscriber model. And also it is suitable for WebSocket. WebSocket is essential for UI interface. So application layer, WebSocket only will helpful. So it is user friendly also. green IoT friendly also, lightweight also, among two communication network layer protocol, TCP/IP protocol and UDP protocol, MQTT is suitable for TCP/IP protocol. You decide which you want. So the fair idea, we just look at intelligent lighting system, daylight, sounds, people's movement are observed. So either you can develop an intelligent lighting based on sound. You can say, hey, come on, light on. If you say, if you create sound, that sound wave vibration is detected and lightly switched on. Or not necessarily to give, hey, come on, light switch on. You can just create any noise, like how sitting and speaking in my room, no, in my cabin. So immediately the moment it senses somebody is there actively involved, then it can switch on. Or else movement, my movement, it can detect, or my physical detection, the appearance of the human need to detect, or light. So different application requires different way of thinking perspective. Similarly, we no need to sense anything. We no need to buy a sensor or smart home automation. Only through our mobile, we can lie down on the bed. We may miss out to switch off the light in the kitchen. So sitting here, we can switch off. What is the number of the light we have given? We need to open the UI application. We need to switch off that light using on off button. So no need of sensor at all for this application. We need to decide. Then instead of sensor, in that case, UI control only will come here. Raw data goes to data lake, extracted information, data lake, it starts extracting the information and it goes to the warehouse. Then from the warehouse, the data can be supplied to the analytics or it can be supplied to the control application. There are certain information directly should go to the control. There are certain information should be given for the analytics for later decision. After control application, acknowledgement also deposited to the warehouse. Suppose I am switching on the motor. So it needs to give me this signal, whether it is switched off or failed to switch it off. So it needs to give. Then from the model, it can take decision to adjust also. From the model also, you can control. Partly you can control through the data also. Then from where actuators, smart lamp comes to the picture. So the relevant command to the actuator need to be given by the control application in order to switch on. Actuator is output. Actuator only will make the thing to happen. Sensor will start the process. In between, these are all required. Layers, servers, and all those things required. Now, just I will discuss sensor-based threat. Extensive literature available. There are several universities working on IoT security itself from, say, Israel. Israel is one of the country. There are several university professors working only on this IoT security itself. So keystroke inference, light, motion, audio, video, light, magnetic sensor, these all can be hacked. That is what I mean to say. So the moment you are using, you know, how you are touching, how you are pressing, which location you are pressing, all those things can be tracked by the hackers. So what you are typing, for example, if you are giving a PIN code for your mobile transaction, so how you are giving your username, how you are giving your password entry, all together through our touch. Because it has a keypad, no? A, Z, the same, I'm looking at my laptop, Q, W, E, R, T, Y, the same order is arranged in the mobile also. So it has that positional arrangement. Where I am touching, that vibration it will detect through light, through motion, through touch. So through that, it is possible to hack our mobile also. Task interference. Similarly, task, you will be giving command, you just go back, what are the tasks available? You are controlling the actuator, you are sensing. So here task comes, sensor senses the task, actuator actualizes the task. So the task can be attacked during the communication. Location inference. So finally, based on the location also, it can go for attacking. Next, eavesdropping. Eavesdropping is one of the method. Many IoT devices uses audio sensors for making calls, recording audio messages, receiving voice commands. So recent day, a lot of serials also they are showing. It is happening also. Even a lot of few celebrities during lockdown, they have got a call exactly from their own friend number. So, but someone else, not their friend at all. So through that, it is possible to detect, deploy audio sensors. They can make these all the kind of activity. Transmitting malicious sensor commands, they can give malicious sensor commands also. Not at all our own sensor command. It will give, for example, look at here, actuator. They can hack, they can switch on all the time. Not at all your own process, you would have done these all the deployment. But that command would have given by the hacker. So it will control, it will be the actuator part alone controlled by those fellows. So most of that is working in autonomous vehicle, all the autonomous two-wheeler, four-wheeler. Recently, BMW released a two-wheeler also, autonomous two-wheeler vehicle also released. Lot of things happening through IoT. They need to be safeguarded. Then especially patient. So health sector require more security. Every sector, not necessarily. Next, false sensor data injection. So they can send similarly like your sensor which you have deployed, false data they can inject. Denial of service, completely they can hack, they can arrest your application, denial of service also they can happen. These are all the level of attacks or threats associated with IoT infrastructure with the minimum level. I am not even touching upon communication level, application level and all, with the minimum level of attack and threats available. Next, LoRa, this is for long range, low power wide area network, LPWAN. Whenever you are using long range, low power wide area network, then you need to go for this LoRa protocol. So this is what one I want to bring, nothing more. So IoT device layer, any device, see, it can be sensor, it can be IoT platform or kit, anything. After that, fog computation. I said fog computation, no? This is kind of several devices together in this cloud, so that fog computation comes. Next, application layer. What do you want to control? Whether you want to control your monitor or your anything else. So that is application layer. Or you can generate report. You can see the data. You can analyze. You can control. You can control the actuator. You can give the command for any services. All together, it becomes application layer. Now, how the data moves? Look at data collection, data transmission, data aggregation, data distribution, data consumption. So these are all the flow of, or this is the way the flow of data happens. IoT characteristics, ambient intelligence. It should be able to, this is for the data or event driven. So either way you can work on data-driven application or event-driven application. Next, ambient intelligence. It should be able to take decision. It should be able to sense what is the input comes. Flexible structure. You may deploy sensors today, maybe smaller in size. Later it may be larger in size. Later it may become dense in nature. So sparse in nature, it should be able to withstand. Semantic sharing, context understanding is important. See, in that lighthouse, there are three contexts are given. This light, look at, there are three contexts. Based on the light, based on the sound, based on the movement. Kinesthetic, acoustic, visual. All the three types of input or inputs are given. So on which input or all the input or combinations, we need to sense. So that is what are the word. This is what semantic sharing, complex access technology. The same device may need to see, for example, your mobile is working on Wi-Fi, your mobile is working on Bluetooth, your mobile is recently working on NFC, that is Samsung Galaxy is working on NFC also. So it should able to communicate with different kind of, interoperable devices. So this is what characteristics of. So now let us look at what is edge computing and the cloud computing. Look at here, there is several source of data comes and flows here. Data and analysis here happens at this level. This level itself, analytics, data analytics will happen. So that is edge computing. cloud computing, it will be deposited via network. See, look at, there is no network at all. Within that, your infrastructure limit itself, computation is happening. Through network, the data is deposited to the cloud. From the cloud only, the computation will happen. That is termed as cloud computing. Next, further micro level discussion, what is edge computing? See, these are all the devices or sensor. The data may go and come out, flow. These devices has sensor or without sensor, the device is. Look at here, real-time data processing, basic analytics is happening, edge level. Edge means that node level, infrastructure level, without even touching into the internet level is called edge computation, please understand. Data catching, buffering, optimization, machine to machine. For after these all analytics, you need to go for filtering, decision making, controlling, and you need to decide what amount of data, what quality of data you need to send into the either data center or cloud. Big data only, we can call it as data center or cloud. So that cost will be reduced. Cloud is most expensive medium, so that we need to reduce the expenditure. For that, we need to take decision what information. For example, surveillance camera, video analytics, those days, whatever the data comes, you need to stream it to server, you need to deploy it to the cloud. Then finally, after a month, after a week, after 2 months, if you don't have any fishy things or nothing is required, then you can sit and delete, or automatic delete can be happen for video footages. Recent date is not recovered. What kind of deduction for if the camera is installed in the ATM, all the malicious activity only it will be deducted, all those activity only it will deposit. Anything goes normal, it will not be deposited to the cloud, only at the local end. That local end will be maintained for a couple of months or a couple of weeks, then that will be deleted, auto deleted, whereas the cloud data will not be deleted. Or few frames per movement, I may enter, couple of frames will be stored in the cloud, or another guy will enter into the ATM, then that ATM bank, that few frame, a smallest footage of every identity. So some logic is applied. So the filtration of data, avoidance of larger information is reduced. So that is also one of the edge computing. Not necessarily to the decision making or controlling the actuators or controlling commands establishment. Sometime data analytics for filtration also may happen at the edge level. It's very popular domain recently, it's going on edge computing. Look at the scenarios. So cloud related, a small tiny cloud attached near to your local area network or near to your computing services is called cloud related. A cloud lit means droplet, we will say, no, it's a tiny cloud, that's all. So look at case one, what is doing edge computing? Going for fog computing or pervasive computing by the cloud lit. The moment we use cloud lit, gateway is essential, a miniature cloud. Then after cloud lit performance, it goes to the cloud. Next, this is edge computing, directly it goes to the cloud. Next, case four, edge and fog computing both are available. Node level computation, local area LAN level computation. After the computation, the data is deposited to the cloud. IoT collecting data from directly data collecting, you are putting it to the cloud. Look at that four scenario. First one does some computation and puts into the cloud lit. From the cloud lit, it goes. Second one, larger computation, edge computation, fog computation, both are happening. After that, it is sent into the cloud. Look at here, first one, it does some computation and it goes to, from the gateway, it does some computation, goes to the cloud. This one directly, there is a device, directly communicates to the cloud. So what kind of service you want, you can take. What is cloud lit? A sensor node. Others remote. There are three types of famous modes are available. You can explore later. Is a node sensor network capable of performing some processing, gathering sensory information, communicating with other connector nodes in the network. That is the role of cloudlet. A mode is a node, but a node is not always a mode. That you should understand. Since when the cloudlet is useful, sensors are deployed heavily, group wise sensor, processor, maybe temperature or pressure extraction, long range communication, short range communication. Based on these all only you need to take decision whether cloud it is required or not. Cloud is an infrastructure established between gateway and to the cloud, in between via media, gateway and the original cloud, in between the cloudlet, a small or tiny cloud. Cloudlet is a mobility enhanced small scale cloud data center. That's all. This is mobility enhanced small scale data cloud center. That's all, data center. So that this will have low latency because it is a nearby infrastructure. Quickly it will work on and it will transfer. Next, features and scope of the IoT system. So the most we have touched upon, unique identity, ubiquity, self-configuration, self-adaptation, interoperable communication, sensing and actuation, programmability. All these features together the scope of an IoT system. Look at here. These are all the layer. Connectivity layer, that is a physical layer, silicon layer, operating system layer, middleware layer, information application layer. These are all cross layer concern. Hierarchy level, this side, A, B, C. So this, you can have product edge, deep edge, gateway edge, edge computation, I was telling now, where the edge is located. Network edge, private edge, co-location edge, public group, public cloud edge. Next, what are all other supporting our interdisciplinary activity? Management, complete infrastructure management, device management, user management. There are three different management: user management, infrastructure management, and device management. Virtualization. Maybe only one operating system will be available. Virtualization, hope so you may be knowing, containerization, virtualization. So it will create a virtual operating system for each and every user. Acceleration, real-time allocation, security. So these are all interconnected, a holistic picture now I am bringing in. The detailed picture to the holistic picture. Hierarchy level, cross-layer level, edge level, and all other supporting services required. These all supporting services. Management, virtualization, acceleration, real-time security, these all supporting services. All together in one picture. Look at here. Now little more detailed picture compared to this picture. Now little more, what are all? Hardware platform infrastructure. What we want to go for? Mechanical, power, cooling, or classic? What kind of thing we want to go for? Protocol abstraction layer and network layer, accelerators we may need to use, computation, storage, node security, hardware security, HW security, OpenFog node management. The several nodes may be playing a role together, node management, hardware virtualization, software virtualization, both are available. Then node management, software backplane, application support, application services. So these all together only it plays. And security, then manageability, data analytics, and minute. There are several notifications. Yeah, finally, application layer. Now these are all the protocol. Look at this hardware protocol, decisions, or control, or reporting. Anything can happen. This is another way of looking at the standards and the protocol, little bit detailed in one picture. So all the IEEE standards related to hardware, hardware related to IEEE standard, or Libelium product you can look at, RFID NFC, RFID VPC. So the, what you want to do, VPN or NFC, all those together we need to take decision. This is called physical layer, data link layer. So it should communicate with data, either Wi-Fi or Zigbee enabled or Bluetooth enabled or RFID enabled, that all together it should have data link layer. Network layer, so IPv4, internet protocol version 4, version 5, version 6, there are three available. You need to sit and study which version is suitable for networking purpose. Or low pan, or RTL, which one we want to use? Transport layer widely used or TCP, next used as UDP. These two are popular. Subsequently TLC, TDLC. Application layer, here another layer, MQTT, XMPP. This is for document XML structured data communication or JSON data. Anything you can represent through this communication. Next is cloud services, device management, business solution, data aggregation, all together can be done with the cloud services. Security, privacy protocol, security protocol, we need to think for every level. Coming to the last level, intelligent transport, smart city, home automation, healthcare, IoT application, anything you can think of. Again, synthesis, but hope so you would be thorough enough by this time. Sensing layer or a physical layer, network domain or communication layer, application layer, this is detailed with micro level information. Smart city, what are the way? Smart city is a famous and a popular projects everywhere going on. Shortly India also will be giving DST fund for smart city also, even nowadays it's available like this. So if you look at intelligent park management, electronic vehicle charging infrastructure, and what else, network routing, traffic light, bus stop control, and LED street light, car charger, information panels, all the information it should give, the layout of that location, all those things, cabinet and water flood or rainfall detection, all those information, temperature detection, it should give complete automated information, pollution control or alert for a certain limit of pollution, motion, video surveillance, all together is termed as smart city. Even you can think of anything goes wrong, immediately ambulance should reach quickly, or the physicians should reach quickly. You should give information nearby the hospitals, nearby hospitals, all together only smart city. You can think of many level, pollution control, greenhouse monitoring, anything you bring to the welfare of the city, it is termed a smart city. That's it. Water metering and all automated, tank filling and interconnection, overflow detection, tank overflow detection, water control, everything you can automate together. And wastewater management, all together you can say as smart city. And all the waste deduction using sensor, whenever it is overflow happens, you know, that dustbin, street dustbin, nowadays periodically whenever those guys are free, they those time only collected all the garbages. So the moment the garbage bin is overflow, it will be detected to the corporation. All together it is said to be smart city. So you can, recent day, smart transportation, most of the developed country, one of the indication is people satisfaction level, and in 24 hours power supply with a cheaper cost is one of the requirement of developed country. So many parameters are available for declaring the country is a developed country. So among that, these all, what it does is, the moment train, it will start detecting the faces of all the passengers. How many seats are available? It will display these many seats only available. You are these many, and wait for this. The other train is nearby. So like India, we will stand on somebody also. That is the way we will travel. We will sit on somebody's shoulder also, we will travel. So that is the scenario in India. There are countries, they don't even allow to stand.